Today we're going to share the story of Hansel and Gretel. Once upon a time, there lived in a woods a little boy and a little girl. They lived there with their father, who was a woodcutter, and every day he would go out and try to collect some wood, but sadly there wasn't much wood to be had. Their mother had died, and so the only other person in the family was their wicked stepmother, who noticed there wasn't enough food for everyone. So one night, when the children were off sleeping, she woke up her husband and said, "Husband, we've got to get rid of those children. There's not enough food for all of us. We've got to take them into the woods and leave them there, all right?" But the husband loved them, so he shook his head. He pounded his fist into his hair. He grabbed his hair, but he couldn't think of another plan. And the wife wore at him until finally he said, "All right." And he agreed to this terrible, terrible plan. Now, little did either one of them know that the children had actually been awake and they were listening to the whole thing. And Gretel turned to Hansel and shook him and said, "What are we going to do?" And Hansel said, "I've got a plan." He snuck out and started to gather little white stones from the ground. He picked up stone after stone and filled his pockets, and then came back into the house and lay down and went to sleep. Now, the next morning, when the wicked stepmother woke them, "Children, it's time to go for a walk, and I'm going to give you one crust of bread. Make it last. It's all you'll get for the whole day. Come along." And they all went off into the woods, marching and marching. But Hansel kept looking back and throwing stones behind him as he went. And when the wicked stepmother said, "What are you doing?" he said, "I'm just waving goodbye to my little white cat on the roof." "That's not a cat. That's the sun glinting off the tin. Hurry along." So they marched and they marched until they got all the way to the middle of the woods, to a clearing where they'd never been before. And then the wicked stepmother said, "Children, stay here until your father and I come back for you." And then she and her husband went off and left them. They left them there all day. And when they got so tired, they fell asleep, leaning against each other and snoring. They snored so loudly, they almost woke each other up. And when they did wake up, it was dark. And Gretel grabbed Hansel's arm and said, "Hansel, what are we going to do?" But he said, "Don't worry, Gretel. We'll just follow the stones. Look, they're shining in the moonlight." And they followed the stones all the way back to their house so that by morning, they were back at home. And their father was overjoyed to see them. But their wicked stepmother, not so much. So she decided to think of a better plan. And that night, after the children had gone to bed, the wicked stepmother said, "Husband, we've got to take them back and lose them this time." But he shook his head. He loved his children so. Unfortunately, she was very persistent. Finally, he gave up. Little did they know that the children had been listening this whole time. And they woke up and went out. Except for one thing. When Hansel tried the door, it was locked. Oh, no. How could he get out? He told Gretel, "Don't worry, Gretel." And she somehow knew things would be all right. Well, in the morning, their wicked stepmother said, "Get up, children. We're going for another walk. And here's a crust of bread. Make it last. It's all you'll get for the day." Then they marched off into the woods, deeper than ever before, to a clearing that they'd never seen. And then she told them, "Wait here for us, children, until your father and I come back for you." And she and the father left. Now the children waited there a long time. They waited and waited, but their parents never came back. They fell asleep, leaning against each other, snoring to wake the birds. And when they did wake, they were alone. Gretel started to cry. And then she grabbed onto her brother's arm and said, "Hansel, what are we going to do?" "Oh, don't worry, Gretel," he said. "We'll find our way. Look, I left breadcrumbs." But when they looked and looked and looked, the birds had eaten all the breadcrumbs. So they started to hike through the woods, hoping by some miracle they might find their way home. And they had hiked and hiked all day when they came to a little house.
and the little house appeared to be made of gingerbread. Oh, the children were so hungry, they started to break off little pieces. There were jelly beans around the window and candy canes in the front lawn. Oh, the children were so thankful that they had found a way to stay alive. But all of a sudden, they heard a voice.
Nibble, nibble like a mouse. Who's that nibbling at my house?
It was an old woman, and she didn't look so friendly.
Don't be afraid, children. I love children. Won't you come in?
So they went in, and she sat them down at her table and fed them until they fell asleep. Right at the table, with their heads practically in the dishes. But when they woke up, Hansel was in a cage, and Gretel was dressed as the maid. She had to do all the work, including fattening up her brother. For the witch said,
"Once you're fat enough, I'll eat you."
And every day she'd say,
"Stick a finger through. I'd like to feel if you're fat enough yet."
But he would stick a chicken bone through. And when she would squeeze, she'd say, "Ah, not fat enough yet." Well, one day the witch was tired of waiting, so she said, "Gretel, heat up the fire 10 times hotter than before. Today I eat your brother." So poor Gretel quickly started to build the fire, wondering how she could save Hansel. And when the witch said, "Well, is it hot enough yet?" Gretel said, "I don't know. How can you tell?" "Like this, you ninny." And the witch showed how you could stick your head right in the oven. And then Gretel gave her a push from behind, and the witch went right in and poof, up in a cloud of smoke. Gretel ran to unlock Hansel. "We're free, we're free." And when she unlocked him from the cage and they grabbed hands and they skipped merrily, merrily through the forest, by some miracle, they found their way all the way back to where their father was waiting. "Father, father, we're home," and they hugged each other. "Oh, Hansel, I'm so glad to see you. Gretel, I'm so glad you're okay." Gretel was so glad to see her dad. And they said, "What about our wicked stepmother? Where is she?" The father shook his head sadly. "She died." "Oh, we shall all live happy.